Okay, Assalamualaikum dan salam sejahtera to everyone. So today I would like to continue our topic. It is about fractional distillation of petroleum. So if you have a textbook with you, can you please turn to page 146? Today we're going to continue about fractional distillation. So we all know that petroleum is actually a mixture of hydrocarbon. Hydrocarbon is actually a compound that consists of hydrogen and carbon element. So, what is fractional distillation? Fractional distillation is a one process where we can separate our hydrocarbon. We can separate the mixture of hydrocarbon into its fraction or its component. Alright, why we can use fractional distillation? It is because the compound of it have a different boiling point. Alright, so fractional distillation of petroleum actually is a process where we separate, alright, we separate the petroleum into the petroleum fractions so that that petroleum can be used in our daily life. So, as we all know, we know that petroleum is actually come from the crude oil. Okay, crude oil. Petroleum come from the crude oil. So now, in activity 5.2, this activity is to show how we can separate crude oil into four different types of petroleum fractions using fractional distillation. So in lab, okay, in lab, we can use this setup, which is we have the crude oil, okay, we put the crude oil and the glass wool inside the boiling tube, and then what we will do, we will heat up the crude oil into a certain temperature. Okay, here we have a thermometer here. Okay, we will boil this crude oil until it reach 360 degrees Celsius. So the vapor that we get, alright, the vapor that we get from the burning, we will collect inside this, okay, inside here. And this is called as a distillate. So this is the setup that we normally use inside the lab. So now, before I go further to the results and discussion about this activity, I would like to show you in daily life, alright, this is the industrial fractional distillation. Okay, this is the industrial fractional distillation. As we all know, we get crude oil from the ocean. Okay, dekat pelantak minyak tu, alright, orang korek kan, okay, orang gerudi untuk mendapatkan minyak, minyak yang dapat tu hitam pekat. And that is called crude oil. So crude oil tu tak boleh guna lagi. Kita kena undergo fractional distillation before it can be used. So what is actually the concept? Concept dia adalah kita nak dapatkan the fraction of petroleum that can be used in our daily life. So nampak tak kat sini kita ada crude boiler. Crude boiler ni maksudnya apa? Alright, kita akan letak crude oil dekat sini. Kita akan masukkan crude oil inside this chamber, and then the crude boiler will heat up this crude oil. Alright, so at certain different boiling point, kita akan dapat different product. So now, kita cuba tengok at 220 degrees Celsius, kita akan dapat gases. And this gases is actually domestic gas, LPG, petrochemical. Alright, kemudian at 70 degree, apa yang kita dapat? Kita dapat nafta. So this nafta we can use as a petrochemical product. Kita turun lagi, we have 120 degrees Celsius, kita akan dapat gasoline. So gasoline normally used in car, gasoline. Now we go further, at 170 degrees Celsius we will get kerosene. Kerosene normally used as a jet fuel. Alright, and also kerosene for lighting and heating. Kalau kita go further lagi 270 degrees, kita akan dapat diesel fuel. Okay, kita akan dapat diesel fuel. So, dekat sini you akan nampak bahawa crude oil, we need to undergo fractional distillation before we can use that crude oil in a type of petroleum fraction. So, kita go to our observation dekat sini. Okay. In lab, alright, kita pakai this set. Dekat lab, kita pakai this set. Okay. kita pakai di set. So kita control the temperature. Kita panaskan sampailah at certain temperature. Kita akan collect distillate dekat sini. So let's see the results. Kita ada 4 fraction here. Okay. Fraction 1 is a range of boiling point around 30 degrees Celsius to 80 degrees Celsius. Range 2, 80 to 150. Range 3, 150 and 230. Range 4, 230 to 250 degrees Celsius. Now, can we observe the color? Alright, we can see that the color changed from the yellow, brown and dark brown. As the boiling point increase, the color become darker. Do you agree with me? As the boiling point increase, the color become darker. Now, we go to the viscosity. For the fraction number 1, it is not viscous. For the fraction number 2, a bit viscous. Fraction number 3, viscous. Well, fraction number 4, very viscous. Sangat likat, pekat. Okay. Well, flammability. Fraction number 1, burn easily but no black smoke. Okay, nice and clean. Burn easily. For fraction number 2, it burn with a bit of soot. Ada sedikit je laga. Fraction 3, burn with black smoke and more soot. Fraction number 4, burn with black smoke and a lot of soot. So, as a conclusion that we can do here is that, ini nota, as boiling point increases, okay, kita akan dapat 2 point. The first point is that the color become darker. And then the viscosity become more or increasing the viscosity. Kelikatan dia lebih pekat. So this is one of the conclusion. Now can we go to this question? Name the method of separation used in this activity. Definitely fractional distillation. So is a petroleum is a compound or mixture? This is a very good question and give your reason. Alright, since we already learned about here, petroleum is a mixture. Why it is a mixture? Because it can undergo fractional distillation. It can be separated at a different boiling point. So that is your reason. It can be separated, right? So definitely your petroleum is a mixture because it can be separated at different boiling point to its petroleum fraction. Okay, so now based on the information from science info in page 146, name the fraction label as a fraction 1. Fraction 1 is a petrol. Fraction 2 is a naphtha. Fraction 3 is a kerosene. Fraction 4 is a diesel. So, what is the characteristics of petroleum fractions is applied in fractional distillation of a petroleum? Very simple. Alright, why we can use fractional distillation? Why we can use fractional distillation? This is because petroleum. Okay, this is because petroleum fraction have different boiling point. That's why we can use fractional distillation. That is the characteristics that cause we can use or that can be used fractional distillation, that we can use fractional distillation like that. So, sampai sini saja. I hope I can see you in the next video. Bye.